Hello and welcome to Rondebosch. It's so exciting to have new parents and grade eights who are going to be joining us next year. This is a first, an introduction evening produced by the boys for the boys. And we want you to know that strict social distancing and COVID-19 protocols were followed and adhered to where possible in order to make this work. Some of the footage you're going to see was shot prior to this year where there weren't any restrictions in place. We know you've probably got a lot of questions about coming to Rondebosch as new grade eight, and we hope to answer as many of them as we can in a live question and answer feature in this video. So please send through your questions on the YouTube comments page and we'll get to as many of them as we can. But first, there are lots of people who want to meet you, so let's get started. Unfortunately, our head boy couldn't be with us in person. He is self-isolating at home, but he still has a message for us. Let's take a look.
Thank you, Alex. And good evening to all of the parents and grade eights of E25. My name is Cameron de Kock, and I want to officially welcome you all to the RBHS family. I remember when, in 2017, we had our own orientation evening, and I was sitting amongst 180 odd boys who had all just finished their grade 7 years at various junior schools. It was a rather daunting and intimidating feeling, especially with the uncertainty of what to expect. I felt a lot less significant while surrounded by, quite literally, some of the best candidates in the country. And while you can't all physically be here together, I'm sure that this feeling will inevitably come. However, I urge you all to remember that you are all here for a reason. Each individual person adds to the brilliance and greatness that will be the class of 2025, whether it be culture, sport, academics, leadership, or even just being remembered for the positive change that you leave behind at the school. As long as you're open to pursuing these opportunities, Bosch will prove to you why it is one of the best institutions in the country. It has a strong sense of brotherhood, where each and every single student should feel welcome and supported, especially by their own grade. It is a guarantee that without the deep support and guidance from my grade, I would not be sitting here addressing you this evening. Keep this in mind when you get here next year. You're all in the same boat as new boys in the school, and sticking together as a cohesive grade will make a massive difference. This sense of unity and brotherhood also comes with an extremely strong set of traditions, and most importantly, geers. Rondebosch is so much more than just a school. It's a culture that gets passed down from generation to generation as they walk through the prestigious hallways of the school. It's an experience that each and every one of you will hold close to your hearts for the rest of your lives. But most excitingly, it's a journey that has only just begun for all of you. Take every single opportunity that you can when you get here, and make the absolute most memories possible. And before you know it, your 5 years at the school will be over in a flash. Just make sure that when you look back at that flash, it's filled with nothing but the absolute best. Altius et Latius.
It's now time for us to meet the Executive Council of 2021 that will be helping the Grade 8s through their first year.
I'm Alex White.
And I'm Thomas Rainham, and we are the Pastoral Portfolio.
I'm Stane Bucker.
I'm Johnny McConnell, and we are the Sport Portfolio.
I'm Albertus van der Merwe.
I'm Robbie Davidson, and we are the Environmental Portfolio.
I'm Nick Ford.
And I'm Ethan Africa. We are the Cultural Portfolio.
I'm Rondo Turin.
I'm Ethan Cunningham, and we are the Academic Portfolio.
I'm Sebastian Ray.
I'm Zahir Holder, and we are the Outreach Portfolio.
I'm Timothy Muthama.
I'm Ziad Bandika.
I'm Kevin Plitterman.
Cameron O'Cock is also part of this portfolio, and we are Social Cohesion.
Those are the 16 guys that are going to be helping you through your first year, who are going to be looking after you and making sure that you really enjoy your time at Bosch. Now let's meet the deputies and the headmaster.
Hello, Grade 8 parents, new Grade 8 boys of 2021. We're so looking forward to having you join us next year, particularly in the face of an incredibly challenging grade 7 year for the boys and for the parents an incredibly challenging year just in terms of getting your sons through. We anticipate and hope that next year will be a more normal year, although clearly there might be some challenges at the start of the year. But we believe that we'll get through those and that your boys will have an opportunity to really integrate themselves into the school and enjoy their time here. I talk about integrating into the school, and I think that's a really important perspective to have as you step onto the school grounds. Rondebosch offers such a broad curriculum. And when I say curriculum, I include both sport and academic work and other cultural pursuits and various clubs and societies and other activities. There's so much to get involved in. It's really important to realize that, and I think I've said this before to several of your parents, that we have over 1,000 applicants to get into this school. The boys of this group make up 180, and that you've been through a process of selection. And that selection process has looked at you and said, this is a boy who will benefit from being at Rondebosch Boys High School. This is a boy who will put time and energy into the school and will draw the best benefit out of it. And so it would be really disappointing if any of those boys who enter the school don't come in with the attitude that they're going to get the most out of it that they can get, that they're going to enjoy themselves as much as they can, and they're going to get involved as much as they can. Because this is a school which thrives on involvement. And that doesn't just go for the boys, that's from a parent perspective too. We love having our parents supporting their boys through the various experiences they have and interacting with our teachers, with our grade heads, with our deputies, as much as possible to ensure that their sons get the full benefit of the school. And the same will work in the opposite direction from the school. We expect our boys to be very fully conversant with the code of conduct when they enter the school, to understand what is expected of them. We understand that parents chose to send their boys to the school for particular reasons, and we expect to have an element of support from the boys in terms of appearance, in terms of behavior, in terms of getting involved and enjoying the school environment. Having said all of that, the rules are just there to ensure that everybody is treated equally. Ultimately, Rondebosch is about immersing yourself in the school environment. It's about enjoying your time here, about making friends, about learning about yourself, about what you can do, about what your limits are, and then exiting the school with a great qualification and with the ability to step into the world confidently because you've received the kind of underpinning that will teach you about how to be a better citizen, how to interact with people from different cultures, different religions, different races, how to enjoy each other's company and hopefully be part of the nation building project which Rondebosch Boys High School would really like to participate in and see our young men becoming part of in the world outside of the school. I wish you well. I hope you have a fantastic journey, and I look forward to meeting you in person next year.
Good day, ladies and gentlemen, and prospective young grade 8s of 2021. My name is Shoket Ibrahim, and I'm the senior deputy headmaster and academic head at Rondebosch Boys High School. As academic head, my main focus is to ensure that the curriculum is delivered to you at a high standard, to ensure that all the assessments in every subject takes place throughout the year, and to ensure that there are structures in place for those learners who are struggling. To do my job effectively, I work closely with the academic management team, subject heads, and subject teachers. The first 2 days of next year will be orientation days for our new boys, where activities such as civic and social responsibility talks will take place, a mathematics streaming test, and athletics prelims. I'd like you to know that we have prepared for your arrival next year and that we are very excited to welcoming you.
Good morning. Welcome to Rondebosch. Now that you and your son have joined this family, I think you will learn next year the most that anybody can get out of the school is by making use of the multiple opportunities offered at the school, not just in the classroom but outside of the classroom. In the multiple, there's huge numbers of clubs, societies, other cultural activities and sport that we do offer. So I want you to encourage your son to be involved. Registration for all these activities will take place next year when they arrive here. But I just want to give one warning. Research in the US has shown that of all kids that start sport when they go to school, that by age 13, 28% have given up on it. The majority of those, the biggest reason why they give up is from pressure by parents and parents trying to overcoach their children. And the number two reason is pressure from coaches. Coaches is our problem. We'll take care of that. But I'm going to ask you to please, for your son, support and encourage, but back off on the pressure. And then he will enjoy his sport. He will enjoy his extracurriculars and he will have a great time at the school. Hope to see you next year somewhere next to a field, a pool or a court. Good luck.
Good afternoon to our parents and Bosch boys, our matric class of 2025. That's what you are. No longer new boys, but Bosch boys. I'm Neil Turbis and I'm our pastoral deputy at Rondebosch. Primarily my job is to ensure that you're cared for, well looked after and that there's development that takes place. We strive to produce boys that are confident to pursue their dreams, boys that are resilient and adaptable, certainly traits that are desperately needed in these trying times. You might be a little bit apprehensive about what Bosch is all about, but I can give you the assurance that at Bosch there is a place for every single one of you. I think it's one of the school's great strengths. Leadership development has become a key issue at Bosch. And in terms of this, we believe that all boys should be given the opportunity. It shouldn't be just for a select few. We believe that leadership development is about mentorship. It's about service. It's certainly something that can be learned. We have staged interventions at each grade. And in our first week next term, the grade 8 boys will have an all-day activity that is geared towards integration, getting to know as many other boys as possible, learning about your strengths and weaknesses, and just have a fun day. In grade 9, the boys have a much needed social literacy conversation at Newlands Cricket Ground. And in grade 10, you will experience the Bosch journey, a 10-day adventure that will take you out of your comfort zone, maybe appreciate your mom's cooking a bit more, but it certainly is an opportunity for boys to interact, to get to know other boys, a respect for themselves, for others, and for nature. And then in grade 11, we take our boys to Calvin Grove, where we bring in old boy facilitators as guest speakers to talk to our boys about what is required beyond school. I welcome you into a proud family, rich in tradition. Despite the trying times that we're in, we have great faith in the future. I thank you.
Finally, we're going to get to those questions you've been sending in on the YouTube comments page. We've got some other things to discuss as well, common issues that come up with boys who are coming to Rondebosch for the first time. So let's get into them. Guys, welcome to our live stream. It's so exciting to have you here with us. We're hopefully going to be answering a bunch of your questions that you've been sending through in the comments already. At the end of the video, we do have a discussion about finance that will also be presented to you. So the parents should probably stay around for that. But to start off, my name is Alex White. You've already heard I'm on the pastoral portfolio. On my left is Mr. Claassen. He's the grade head. And on my right is Mr. Paarman, who is the pastoral grade head. And they'll explain the difference between the two of them a bit later on. And then behind me, they'll introduce themselves.
My name is Thomas Rainham, and I am with Alex White on the pastoral portfolio.
My name is Ethan Cunningham, and I'm on the academic portfolio.
My name is Timothy Muthama, and I'm on the social cohesion portfolio.
I'm Ziad Bandika, and I'm on the social cohesion portfolio.
Cool. So we don't have all 7 portfolios represented at the moment. You saw all 16 of us a little bit earlier on. But with this group, we do have quite a diverse range of Rondebosch involvement represented. So hopefully that we'll be able to answer a lot of your questions and as many of your questions as we can. The first one that we've got here is kind of important because of the time we're in for Mr. Claassen is around what safety measures have been put in place by the school in terms of COVID-19.
All right. In terms of COVID-19, we're very much guided by the national guidelines. So depending on certain lockdown levels and safety measures that are put in place, we'll run at a certain percentage of capacity within classrooms. Boys arrive at school in the morning and are screened for any symptoms that they might have. Their temperature is taken, and this is recorded on a national database brought up by the Education Department, which helps us monitor any changes in those measures or in those symptoms. Furthermore, inside the school building, we insist that boys wear masks at all times. And there is sanitizing stations set up all over the school, as well as when boys enter classrooms, they have to sanitize their hands. And then there are also quite stringent cleaning protocols kept at the end of each day. For that reason, this year we've ended school a little bit earlier than usual. Normally we end at 3 o'clock, we cut school a bit early so that we can give the school a proper clean at the end of each lesson or during breaks and at the end of the day. Other than that, we are very much guided by what the Education Department tells us we need to implement depending on where the country is at.
And then Mr. Paarman, would you be able to explain the difference between you and Mr. Claassen as the two grade heads?
Well, the partial head, obviously, at the Rondebosch works usually over a five-year period. In other words, I will continue with the same grade through to grade 9, 10, 11, and 12, which could be a good thing or a bad thing. Obviously, it's quite important that we get on quite well. Mr. Claassen deals, obviously, with the issues regarding particularly the grade 8 issues, and obviously, it's like the discipline side of it. And things that I would deal with would be things like family issues, boys that are struggling, calling in parents, talking to particular boys, but not necessarily on the disciplinary front. So that's the major difference between the grade head and the pastoral head.
Okay, cool. And then let's talk about next year when the boys come into grade 8. A couple questions here about, will there be a tour of the high school and how will the learners be split into different classes?
Right, I'll grab that one. By next week, we will send out a introductory booklet with loads of information, school rules, uniform rules, when the school shop is open, and a little map of the grounds. In that, you have the program for the first 3 days. Over the first 3 days, there's a specific program for the grade eights, and part of that is a tour by the lovely gentleman from the executive, where they'll show them around. I prefer that the executive does that because one of the standing jokes will be to show boys to where the pool is rather than where the maths rooms are. And along with allocation to classes, which is done predominantly on creative arts choices. Boys that take music have to be in a certain grouping. Other than that, we try to balance boys based on their surnames for this year, especially where we went down to a 50% capacity, and we went boys with surname A to L. Other than creative arts choices, it is purely random. We try not to meddle too much at this stage. Obviously, going on to grade 9, it's a different story. And yes, that booklet, along with a load of other information, like our learner management system, Engage, our education management system, Google Classroom, all of that information will get to you within the next week or so.
And then I mentioned that our panel here is made up of boys who are involved in different aspects of school. So we're going to look now a couple of questions with regards to culture and sport. And the first one I'm going to put to Tom Rainham about culture and how exactly that works when you come to grade 8.
Right. So at the beginning of grade 8, when you apply to Rondebosch, you get given a choice of doing the three cultural subjects. They are visual arts, music, and drama. Each one of these would be your major creative arts subject, but each one also comes with a minor subject, which is touched on once or twice a term. And for art, your minor subject will be drama. For music, your minor subject will be drama. And for drama, your minor subject will be art. These minor subjects are compulsory. You cannot decide what they are, but you can decide what your major subject and subsequent minor subject is. Once you get to grade 10, you will be able to choose your own single art, creative art subject. This could be either music, art, or in drama's case, this is done outside of Rondebosch with Rustenburg Girls High School.
Cool, thanks Tom. And then Ziad, touching on that, we were talking about, Tom mentioned, when you get to grade 10, you'll choose your subject. So can you touch on that just a little bit?
Yes, so in grade 9, usually around September time, you get spoken to about subject choices. You'll be an evening usually with parents and students in the hall where each of the subject heads will kind of introduce the subject. And by that time, you should have known where your interests and passions lie. The selection process starts during towards the end of grade 9 to between term 3 and term 4. And if at any time you need to change subjects or drop a subject or take extras if you can, you can do that throughout your period from grade 10 to grade 12.
And then following on from that, yeah, we've got a question that just came in. Will there be a space for Muslim boys to pray?
Yes, there is. So we have a prayer facility. It is well maintained, it's cleaned often, and we can use it at any time that you need to pray, after school hours or during school. It is open.
Cool, thanks Yad. And then I think one here for one of our teachers is, on what date should the boarders come to school?
Okay, so the boarders, everybody else is returning on the Wednesday, and the boarders are returning on the Tuesday. The time for the boarders, it's at 11 a.m. and obviously mom and the family can drop them off at 11 a.m. on the Tuesday. After the boys are settled in the boarding house on the Tuesday, mom and dad will leave probably about an hour and a half or so, and then the boys will go into lunch. And by that said, I'll say goodbye to mom and dad. And then in the afternoon, after they had their first meal, the rest of the boarding house will return. That's grades 9 to 12. They will return between 4 o'clock and 6 o'clock. At that stage, the whole boarding house will be back. So boarders, you return at 11 o'clock, or expected at 11 o'clock, with all your possessions outside Mason House on the Tuesday.
Thanks. We've got quite a few boarding house specific questions coming through, so people want to contact someone for more information about boarding and the process going into boarding, who should they talk to?
Well, the head of the boarding house is of the junior boarding house is Trevor Edwards, Mr. Edwards. He's the head of the house. The head of the entire boarding house is Mr. Pinner. So just to most boards will probably know this, but grade 8s and 9s live in one boarding house called Mason House, 10s, 11s and 12s in another boarding house called Canigo. But as a house, you have day boy houses and boarders, all the boarders live are part of one house called Canigo, but they live in two residences, the junior boarding houses, grade 8 and 9, being Mason House, 10, 11s and 12s being Canigo.
And then to add on to that, in general, if they need more information, they can contact Kathy Duncan, who is the hostel manager.
Okay, great. And then I mentioned that we were going to talk about culture and sport. So now a question to do with sport. Obviously, this year has been very different. Sports had to be very different. So hopefully, Ethan, you can just touch on how sport's been working during this time.
Yes. Unfortunately, with regards to winter sports, we didn't really manage to get in a season this year due to COVID, as I'm sure a lot of people lost out on a lot of things. But going forward, for non-contact sports, we've been able to start playing matches now, ensuring things like physical distancing and sanitizing and working on that front to stay safe during COVID. And then for contact sports, we've also been working hard to be able to train there as well, because obviously at a school like Rondebosch, sport is obviously a big thing. So we're really keen to try and get as much sport as we can in. So to do that, we've obviously been ensuring that we've been practicing like safety protocol while still being able to train for sport at the same time.
And Rondebosch has, obviously, if you came on open day, you would have seen some of the different sporting facilities. So, Tim, maybe you can touch on things that we've got, like gyms, etc.
All right. So, our school has two school gyms run by an outside organization, but it is a lovely facility where boys can simply just come in and exercise if they want. We also have two indoor basketball courts known as the Mears in the gym. and one outdoor court which is found around the tennis courts. We also have two swimming pools, two main hockey astros, and a couple of rugby and cricket fields, which are open just to, for anybody to play on. So that's about it.
Cool. And then we did mention at the start that we have a bunch of portfolios. We said there's seven of them. It's part of the 16 executives. So Ethan, maybe you can talk a bit about how we've changed from being prefects to executives and how we're structured.
Yeah. So we found that in the past, sometimes with not as much structure, it's been a little bit difficult for the prefects to sort of find a specific area in which they can work in. So we've been, a lot of chat has been coming around the school, we've had a lot of discussions, and we found that one of the best ways we can go forward with transformation and change is by sort of restructuring the student leadership. And to do this, we've formed seven portfolios. So now there's two boys in each portfolio and four in social cohesion. So we've each been given a role where we can really implement change, and we can really work hard in those areas like academics, sport, culture, pastoral, social cohesion, and environment and outreach as well. Those are the portfolios.
Awesome. And then Ethan, one more on there. When does sport begin for the grade eights, or is that dependent on COVID?
Yeah, so depending on obviously the different sporting codes, because we'll have summer sports starting for the grade eight. For a lot of the sports, often either after the orientation day in the afternoon, there's some sort of group, there's sort of like a trial area where they just, the coaches get to meet the boys and the boys get to meet the coaches, and just like an introduction into the different sports. But obviously, depending on COVID next year, will help determine when that actually happens.
Awesome. Thank you. So thank you to everyone for your questions. If you do have more questions, there are email addresses available for both our grade heads, or for both of the grade 8 grade heads. That will be in the description, in the comments, and also in the video itself a little bit later on. There's now going to be a presentation by the business manager, Mr. Coots, around finance at Rondebosch going into next year. So thank you so much for watching. And one of the other questions, will this webinar be available after today? Yes, it will be. You can go onto the Rondebosch YouTube channel and watch it back as many times as you want. Thanks so much for joining us.
Greetings to you as the incoming parents to the high school facet of the Bosch family. I would like, on behalf of the non-administrative staff, to welcome you. I know that the time and money spent with our school will be a good investment for you and your family and bring you many positive benefits. Rondebosch Boys High School is a quintile 5 public school, which means that it receives minimum assistance from the state, an amount of about 264,000 rand out of a budget spend of 50 million rand, plus 23 teachers out of a total of 54 teachers. It therefore relies very heavily on the parents to pay the agreed annual fees. Historically, 94% of fees due have been so paid. And in fairness to all, despite the ongoing tight economic circumstances, this is a level we must all strive to maintain. Because a budget allows for no surplus, any fall off of fee collection, as you can imagine, will have the effect of increasing fees more rapidly for the remaining parent body. Fees covering those expenses that are catered for in the school budget include certain extramural activities. They do not, though, cover the likes of sport or cultural tours, which should be self-funding, and do cover certain specific items such as textbooks. The details of the budget are available, should you require them, from the business manager. Fees are required to be set annually during a meeting of parents, where the planned income and expenditure is explained and resultant fees discussed and agreed to. The proposed fees for the 21 year were thus presented to the parent body on the 4th of November, and an annual fee of 60,000 per pupil per annum agreed. This represents a 5.63% increase over the fees of 2020, and is the second year in succession that the fee increase has been at record lows. The parents resolve in the aforementioned budget meeting that school fees for the year are payable on the first day of the academic year. The school will grant a 5% discount in respect of those fees that are settled before the end of February. And given current interest rates, this is a real saving and worth going for. The other option is to pay fees over 10 equal monthly installments between January and October, and to allow the school to create a debit order accordingly. This method has benefits for all parties and is popular. One of these two methods needs to be selected, and communication has been sent out to you in this regard. Where a parent has chosen to pay over 10 months and then for whatever reason misses a payment, there is an acceleration clause which has the effect of making the full unpaid balance for the year immediately due. Should debit orders be returned and additional charges incurred, or where the school incurs legal charges in the collection of fees, it does reserve the right to pass these costs back onto the defaulter. School fees, I'd like to stress, are a statutory debt and are a joint and several liability of both natural parents. This statute overrules divorce orders, so care and communication between parents is needed to ensure that the fees are duly covered. Cash payments, which for safety and security reasons the school discourages, need to be made to the bursar's office and a receipt obtained. Card payments can be made through the shop, through the school shop, using Master or Visa card. Unfortunately, we do not take Diners Club. We encourage parents to preferably transfer cash amounts from their own bank or ATM accounts to the school. Please use your son's name and his account number as a reference. If you are making cash payments at the school, please do so directly at the bursar's office and obtain the necessary receipt. Fee payments, fee statements are sent out monthly via email. We ask that physical, postal, and email addresses, as well as telephone numbers, are kept current at all times, and that any changes to any of them are advised to the school clearly and in writing. This is vitally important for many, many reasons. Except for the grade 10 journey, extraneous charges such as tours, tournaments, etc. do not appear on your fee statement. You will receive correspondence concerning these and are asked to pay them promptly when due. Please be extra careful with your payment references when making these payments to assist correct allocation. The school is utilizing the Carry system, which app in association with Nedbank assists the collection of these extraneous charges, communicating directly with the school and the parents involved. Our school fee bursar, Ms. Tana Presley, whose email address rbhs.fees@rondebosch.com, is happy to clarify any fee matters with you, and I would suggest you communicate your concerns with her accordingly. So far as music is concerned, music fees are determined based on instrument choice, insurance, number of instruments taken, tutors, etc. These fees will be included on your February school fee statement and can be paid over 9 months should you so select from February to October. Of course, the discount does not apply to music fees, but authority can be given to adjust your debit orders to incorporate it. Section 21, assistance. In terms of the SA Schools Act, provision is made for assistance to be granted for the settlement of school fees, which through defined circumstances of financial hardship cannot be fully paid. It is based on the gross annual income of both natural parents. Post the parent budget meeting, correspondence was sent out which included the yes-no questionnaire. This is a state form asking questions concerning Section 21 assistance, which form is required to be signed and returned to the school by all new parents. If you haven't returned yours, please do so. Assistance should only be applied for where parental financial circumstances have changed adversely subsequently to being accepted for admission to the school. Financial assistance is not intended for parents to be able to put their children into the school which they cannot afford. It is for those parents who can afford the school fees and who, due to unforeseen circumstances during their student's term at the school, can no longer afford either the full or partial of the fees to receive assistance. Where required, assistance should be requested in respect of each year, and the maximum fees that you are able to pay must please be committed to. Full details, as required in the relevant forms, need to be provided. Financial assistance is in respect of school fees cannot be granted to parents to enable a pupil to stay in the hostel or to facilitate the funding of other expensive or elective things such as rowing or voluntary tours. School fee settlement is a statutory obligation and takes preference over these items. The capital funding donation that parents are asked to pay, if at all possible, is a donation to the school of an amount of $2,500 or whatever other amount suits, which is kept separately in the campus development fund. The school budget is constrained, and extra funding for development costs makes all kinds of things possible that would otherwise not be possible. And these donations definitely enhance the standards and facilities going forward. In 2020, the school received an extra 360,000 Rand in this regard, which greatly assisted us complete certain projects like the walkway, which otherwise would not have happened. We would seriously hope that at least 40% of our parents agree to making this extra commitment and take their contributions towards this very important source of additional revenue to the school. It benefits both the school and its pupils. We requested the school will issue a Section 18A tax certificate in respect of these contributions, which will have the effect of making them tax deductible. Always fun to have the government pay towards your school. Commitment towards these development contributions are agreed to in advance, and correspondence has been sent to you. Please give it, therefore, due consideration. If you require, it can be spread over 10 months and will appear on your monthly fee statement. It may, of course, be settled up front, but then, of course, no discount would be given on this. Tours. Tours do not typically form part of the school budget and need to be paid for separately. They are anticipated to be self-funding and need to be paid for before departure. Communication will be received should your son be involved in tours. Fundraising. Main school fundraising is through My School Card, where a percentage of school, where the school receives a percentage of purchases from certain retailers, the most important of which is Woolworths. If you or your greater family become members of these Woolworths My School Card shoppers, please ensure that they do, if at all possible, maximize the use. Over 120,000 rand was received from this source in 2019, and it comes at no extra cost to you, the shopper. Make sure, please, that you or your extended family do become members of the My School Card program. Mrs. Ogilvie, marketing at rondebosch.com, can be contacted in this regard, but you will also find the Should you need them, you will also find the cards in the Woolworth shops. A note, please, just to remind everybody, purchasing uniform items for your son becomes very, very hectic towards this time of year and in the start of early next year. I would earnestly therefore request you to do your uniform shopping now, sooner rather than later, as the school has selected as a marking centre and will effectively be closed to the public next year until the 22nd of January, leaving very, very little time before the school starts, before you are able to do shopping. There will be notices on the web as to when the shop is open. I'd like to thank you for your attention and wish you all well over the festive season. Didn't you believe in me? This is our day. Gonna paint the world in color. This is our day. And they'll never hear a stutter. This is our day. There's nothing, nothing you can do. Cause we're gonna shine.